Good evening and welcome to Cheltenham College's Chapel. Please be seated. Well, today we celebrate the feast day of Richard Hooker, one of the most influential theologians in the 16th century, and who also allowed the Anglican Church to make sense of the complexity of faith. And we are lucky to have the choir Canticum singing for us, and they now sing Psalm 18. Our first lesson is taken from the third chapter of the letter to the Philippians, beginning to read at the third verse. For we are the circumcision, who worship God in the Spirit, rejoice in Christ Jesus, and have no confidence in the flesh, though I also might have confidence in the flesh. If anyone else thinks he may have confidence in the flesh, I more so. Circumcised the eighth day, of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of the Hebrews, and concerning the law, a Pharisee, concerning zeal, persecuting the church, concerning the righteousness which is in the law, blameless. But what things were gained to me, these I have counted loss for Christ. Yet indeed, I also count all things loss for the excellence of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as rubbish, that I may gain Christ. Here ends our first lesson. We stand to hear the Magnificat.
Thank you.
The second lesson is taken from the 15th chapter of the Gospel of St. Luke, beginning to read at the first verse. Then all the tax collectors and the sinners drew near to him to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes complained, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." So he spoke this parable to them, saying, "What one of you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I found my sheep which was lost.' I say to you that likewise there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 just persons who need no repentance. Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she's found it, she calls her friends and neighbors together, saying, 'Rejoice with me, for I found the piece which I lost.' Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents." Here ends our second lesson. We stand for the Nunc Dimittis. Turning to face the altar, we affirm our faith together in the words of the Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Our anthem this evening is by the 16th century High Renaissance English composer Thomas Tallis. Canticum sings his four-part motet, If Ye Love Me. So let us pray. A prayer for the Church of God, that she might reveal something of God's glory here on earth. O God, make the door of this house wide enough to receive all who need human love and fellowship, narrow enough to shut out all envy, pride, and strife. Make its threshold smooth enough to be no stumbling block to children, nor to straying feet, but rugged and strong enough to turn back the tempter's power. God, make the door of this house the gateway to thine eternal kingdom. Amen. And a prayer for our government in these difficult times. Most gracious God, the author of all good things, we humbly beseech thee for the Parliament of the United Kingdom at this time assembled, that thou wouldest be pleased to direct and prosper all their counsels to the advancement of thy glory, the good of thy church, and the safety, honor, and welfare of all people. All this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our most blessed Lord and Savior. Amen. And as war continues to be waged and lives lost, we pray for peace. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray thee, in the hearts of all people the true love of peace, and guide with thy pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that, in tranquility, thy kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of thy love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we end our prayers by saying together the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen. Well, by way of notices, the next Choral Evensong is next Thursday, 10th of November, 6 p.m. Schola Cantorum will be singing Stanford's Evening Service in A, and our anthem will be Vaughan Williams' Lord Thou Hast Been, and you're, of course, warmly welcome to attend. And our thanks go this evening to Canticum for their beautiful singing. Could you please stand for God's blessing? The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. Amen.